I've lived in the US. I go and work in the China, in China very, very often. I tell you something. Very different. The picture that's painted for us is very different from reality. Here we have very junior ministers saying things like when Dr. Lily Neo says, you know, Vivian, I think we should give the poorest 3,000 families in Singapore an increase in their subsidies. And what does the Minister of Community Development and Youth and Sports say? He says, what? He says what? How much you want? What kind of meal do you want? You want a meal in a restaurant, a food court, or a coffee shop? You know, in any other country, you will not have a public official or an elected minister saying these words, unkind words, to his voters. The Singaporean minister dares to do it because we have let him. This time, we will not let him and we will not let them. No, seriously. Let me just share with you. Sichuan earthquake, okay? Wen Jiabao, he rushes to the scene. He sees these kids, all right? He sees these kids. The parents are no longer there. He hugs them. His tears just start falling, you know? He's hugging them. Just feeling, you know, for his people. You ever see our ministers cry, right? Only when they are retired too early. Let me share with you 911. Okay? President George Bush. Now, we all don't really think he's a very clever man. Right? Unlike, apparently, we are supposed to have this first-class cabinet, remember? In today's Straits Times, we have a first-class cabinet that can go anywhere in the world. Well, President Bush from my school, Yale University, yeah? Not very smart man, but he got a heart. In the middle of 911, there he was on the streets. You know what he was carrying? He was carrying a fireman's shoe. Wait, let me explain to you. He was carrying a fireman's shoe, standing at a street corner, collecting donations for the firemen who died in 911. Standing in a street corner, collecting donations for the firemen. You think Vivian Balakrishnan is going to be doing this? In addition to the minister mentor telling us that we will regret it, our senior minister also reminded us that a first world parliament is not what we want. We need a first world government. Tonight, I just want to leave you with this message. Singaporeans deserve both a first-class government and a first-class parliament because in the 52 years that we've been standing here, Singaporeans have turned into a first-class electorate. That is who we have become. Jurong Industries was built by us. Temasek Holdings came about because of our efforts and our family's efforts and our parents' efforts and our grandparents' efforts. Not the bunch of elites who now tell us to get out of their elite face. these elections, please think very, very wisely. The time is not going to be this chiku right again. The PAP always wants to remind people or to scare people and say that, oh, the opposition is untried and the opposition is fragmented. Not true. Not true. Take a look over the last 3 weeks. There is only one ward left. I think it's Sengkang East, or that has got a three-cornered fight. Everywhere else, all the opposition parties have managed to work out their differences and put the interests of Singaporeans first and foremost. What am I trying to say? I'm trying to say that we today deserve your support, because we are prepared to undo what the PAP has been doing, which is to put you last behind their foreign friends and behind themselves. We are not. Let me tell you one simple example of what we at the Singapore Democratic Party is prepared to do. If you take a look at our SDP promise, number one is very simple. All successful SDP candidates who become MPs will contribute 50% of our MPs' allowance to improve our party's service to you and to seed an endowment fund for the needy. That's it. That's it. Look, I don't have to tell you, the path of an opposition politician is not easy. I don't want to talk about that. I'm not interested in that, because we all know we go in with our eyes open. But what I do want to tell you is this. We are definitely not doing this for the money. There is only one reason why those in the opposition ranks, and in particular the SDP, do what we do, is because we think we can do better for you. It's because we think we will be capable of putting you at the heart of our policy making. On nomination day, on behalf of the SDP, I waged war with the PAP. Yes! And I said, I used a couple of Chinese phrases. I'm going to say that first and I'm going to translate it in English. I said something very simple, and I'd like you all to listen very carefully and maybe to repeat after me. 世界上 没有赢不了的战，新加坡也没有打不败的对手。我今晚见到你们，我知道我们人民的胜利在眼前。 So basically what I said is, I'm going to translate for some of those in the audience who don't speak Mandarin. I basically said, there is no war in this war. No war in this world that cannot be won. And in Singapore, there is no foe that cannot be defeated. Seeing all of you here tonight, I can feel it. Just like the senior minister did many years ago, I can also feel it in my bones. Victory, victory with you here is just within sight. Thank you, everyone.